Michael Clark emotional tribute to Philip Huggins. Michael Clark said he was so proud of MacBilly and it's easy to say why today. Taken from USL at the age of 25, he left mark on our game that leaves no embarrassment. I don't know about you, but I keep looking for him. I know it's crazy, but I expect any minute to take a call from him or see his face pop around the corner. Is this what we call the spirit? If so, then his spirit is still with me, and I hope it never leaves. I walked out into the middle of the SCG on Thursday night. Those same blades of grass beneath my feet, where he and I and so many of his mates here today have built partnerships, taken chances and lived out the dreams we painted in our heads as boys. The same stands where the crowds rose to their feet to cheer him on, and the same fans he sent the ball to time and time again. It's now forever the place where he fell. I stood at the wicket and knelt down to touch the grass, and I swear he was with me, picking me up off my feet to check if I was okay, telling me we just needed to dig in and get through to D, telling me off for that loose shot I should played, chatting about what movie we had watched that night, and then passing on a useless fact about cows. I could see him swagger back to the other end, grin at the bowler, then call me through for a run. With such a booming voice, a book in the car park could hear it. The heart of a man who lived his life for his wonderful game we play, who so sandwiched not just our sport but all of our lives. Is this what indigenous Australians believe about a person's spirit being connected to the land upon which they walk? If so, I know they are right about the SCG. His spirit has touched it, and it will forever be a sacred ground for me. And I can see how he has touched so many people around the world. The tributes to him from cricket lovers across the globe have kept me going. The photos and the sense of communion in his sense of loss has shown me his spirit is in action. It has sustained me and overwhelmed me in equal measures. And the love of my band and baggy green and gold brothers and sisters have held me upright when I felt I could not proceed. Philip's spirit, which is now part of our game forever, will act as a custodian of the sport we all love. We must listen to it. We must cherish it. We must learn from it, dig in and get through to D, and we must play on. So rest in peace, my little brother. I will see you out in the middle.